Large Descemet membrane detachments during cataract surgery can be a nightmarish experience for the cataract surgeon. Let me recount one such horror story. A routine day at work. This was the 8th case of my list. An elderly lady with a white and a mature cataract. I'm extremely cautious and my primary goal is to meticulously remove the cataract without damaging the endothelium. I'm using repeated injections of dispersive OVD to protect the endothelium. All is well, I thought. The phacoemulsification is being performed in a very controlled manner. This is the last piece, finish it and put in the lens and the job is well done. Well, destiny had something else in store for me. Something happened and my worst fears became a reality. I was staring at a giant Descemet membrane detachment extending all the way from my temporal phacoincision to the inferior side port. Well, I needed to quickly prioritize my next few steps. I needed to ensure that the detachment does not extend still further. I'm using OVD to gently unfold the Descemet's membrane and to provide a temporary tamponade. Then, under the cover of the viscoelastic, I'm implanting the foldable lens into the bag. Care is taken that I'm not going to strip off the membrane which is loose at the phaco incision. The haptic is dialed into the bag. Now I'm removing the OVD by gently aspirating it out. At this moment, I make a decision of injecting SF6 gas instead of an air, since I was dealing with a huge detachment and thought it was a better bet since it provides a longer tamponade. I wanted to fix this case once for all and never wanted the patient to come back to the OT. 20% concentration of the SF6 gas was used. After the initial overfill of 3 minutes, small amount of gas was released to minimize IOP rise. 4 hours later, the cornea is edematous but the gas pebble was supporting the DM. The DM was attached. I thought the job was done. The DM was attached forever. 2 days later, the patient has come for follow-up. The patient is not happy. I receive a phone call and I'm told that the OCT shows that the Descemet membrane has re-detached and the gas bubble has shrunk. So I said, send the patient back to OT, I'll redo it again. Topical anesthesia, fresh side port is done. The eye is soft, difficult to find the original side port. Make a new one and inject SF6 gas again. Patient is uncomfortable. Later, we examine at the OCT. The tamponading seems to be adequate. The DM looks good. We advise supine position. Case to be reviewed 2 days later. I'm confident this time the DM has attached forever. Well, how wrong was I? 2 days later, the same story continues. The Descemet's membrane has re-detached again. Well, I'm surprised and shocked, and the patient's reactions are not surprising, telling them that they require another injection. Well, I promised the patient that this certainly will be the last time, but deep inside, I wasn't sure. So here I am, injecting the gas for the third time. Patient refused to stay back overnight at the hospital. She wants to go back home. She's advised supine position. Next day morning, she presents in a bad state. She has severe pain and has vomited 6 times through the night. Pupillary block is seen, antechamber is flat, the gas has gone behind the pupil, pressure is 60 millimeters. She's in a miserable state. However, the Descemet membrane is perfectly attached. I thought at least one positive thing during this painful phase. Under topical anesthesia, at the slit lamp, the gas is released by pressing at the side port using a sterile candela. The patient started feeling better immediately. The Descemet's continued to be attached even after the gas was removed. I felt the DM won't detach again since it was pushed back against the stroma with such high pressure for many hours overnight. I was thinking finally the DM has attached forever. 2 days later, it was attached. I thought my ordeal is finally over. Well, 2 weeks later the patient comes to follow up. My horror continues. The Descemet's membrane has indeed detached again. Deep inside, it seemed I had lost all hope. Keratoplasty seemed the only option. I decided to get it done by my corneal surgeon friend, for which the patient needed to travel to a different city. Literature review revealed only one study on repeat descemetopexy, which showed high success rate with only two attempts of gas injection. But in my case, three attempts of gas tamponade had failed. At this stage, I remembered the eternal Hindi film dialogue.
I'm sorry. Ab ise dawa ki nahi, dua ki zarurat hai.
I convinced the patient for one last-ditch effort before keratoplasty. I pushed in SF6 gas 20%. Everything was done the same. The only additional thing was prayer. The next day, the Descemet membrane was attached. Well, not surprised, I told myself. I've seen this before. 1 week later, the Descemet membrane is still attached. Now the hopes begin to rise. 3 weeks later, the Descemet membrane continues to remain attached. The cornea is clear. Yes, the Descemet membrane is finally attached, and forever. The patient was smiling after a long, long time. Seeing the joy on the patient's face was priceless. I just forgot my month-long misery. So what did we learn from this case? Descemet membrane detachment was recurring every time the gas bubble size shrunk. This was primarily because of the poor functioning of the endothelial pump in this patient. The pump was failing to prevent the accumulation of fluid, ultimately leading to recurrent Descemet detachment. It showed that it could take some time for the endothelial pump to kick in. Until then, the Descemet membrane needs to be adequately supported by using long-acting gas. Contrary to the conclusion in this published report stating that air and C3FET are equally efficacious and air is to be preferred, this case clearly demonstrates that in certain situations, long-acting gases are definitely better. Inferior Descemet membrane detachments are very challenging to manage. Long-acting gases have a definite role in their management, as suggested by this another report. However, pupillary block, secondary glaucoma are expected complications, and close monitoring is critical to ensure better outcomes. Repeat desmetopexy definitely has a role to play in eyes with these recurrent detachments. And finally, there's always hope.